Hi YouTube, this is Born With A Veil, and I know a lot of you probably don't know what the symptoms of narcissism. I'm gonna give you a couple, okay? It doesn't matter if you're male or female, and it doesn't matter what sign I'm talking to. These are your signs and symptoms of narcissism. So one is lives in a fantasy world that supports their delusions. There are a lot of narcissist people that live in a fucking fantasy world that supports their delusions. They're delusionalists. I mean, they'll make up stuff in their head and swear that it's the truth. Swear that it's happening. Okay? And it's not. Needs constant praise and admiration. As long as you're telling them how beautiful they are, how handsome they are, how sexy they are, how good they are, that's a constant praise. It lifts them up, okay? A sense of entitlement. Exploits others without guilt or shame. They don't give a damn, okay? And this is happening in a lot of relationships. Frequently demeans, intimidates, bullies, or belittles others. So if you're with a narcissist that frequently demeans you, and that's abuse. They put you down, they call you names, they intimidate you, they bully you, they threaten you, they blackmail you, they belittle others to you. That's a narcissist. And a narcissist personality disorder, okay? One of several conditions in which people have an inflated sense of their own importance. A deep need for excessive attention and admiration, troubled relationships, or a lack of empathy for others. Okay? When you're a narcissist, you don't give a shit about nothing but your own needs. Okay? And these are some tips dealing with a narcissistic personality. They want you to accept them. Break the spell, speak up, set your boundaries, expect a pushback, but remember the truth and find support and demand action, okay? Can a narcissist love you? They acknowledge your existence when you serve your purpose to them. So, if they're using you and using for their own shit, then you serve a purpose to them. But if you're not doing for them anymore, if you're not taking care of them, if you're not giving them money, if you're not giving them sex, if you're not doing what they want you to do, then you served your purpose at that time. You could be in a relationship for a couple years and you took care of their ass. You did everything you could for them, but when they're finished with you, that's a done deal. They don't care anymore. That doesn't even exist. It's what you can do for them right now. Okay? You served their purpose. A person who is not separate from you cannot love you because they cannot see and know you. It's as if you are one being, the narcissist. You as a separate, distinct, the individual cannot be appreciated. Is a narcissist capable of change? One girl said it's not easy. She said they are also capable of empath once they engage in the hard work of truly knowing themselves at the deepest emotional level. Facing the underlying shame and insecurity and loneliness that often lies beneath their blustery exterior. Okay? What do narcissists fear? Narcissists feed heavily on the admiration of others. Without people, they are nothing. So they feed off of you like a disease. If they can't feed off of you, then what? And it's not so much them, it's you. You're nothing to them, okay? That's why one of the biggest fears for a narcissist is to complete the lack of admiration from others. This is not quite as feared as being shamed by others, but it's very close. Okay? You know, dealing with a narcissist is some bullshit. Okay? It really is. It drains you like a vampire. Okay, that's somebody that if you're an empath and they suck the life right out of you, the emotions, it's something like a narcissist to me. Okay, how do you leave a narcissist? Here's some ways that you can leave a narcissist. Steps to leaving an abusive relationship with a narcissist. That's very, very tough. Don't give them one more chance. Don't tell them you're leaving. Make copies of all your documents, social security cards, license, marriage, whatever that documents that you have, okay? Make sure you have spare cash. Report what's happening to you, to a counselor, to a police, somebody that you can trust, a psychiatrist. Log out of everything. Don't leave nothing for them to find, okay? And check your devices for trackers, because they will track your shit. And don't believe their flattery. It's an abusive relationship. Some of you are in a narcissistic relationship that's abusive. You think it's abuse, but that person is narcissistic. Okay? They're a narcissist. They're a narcissistic narcissist. Okay? Now, here's some signs about a narcissist, about abuse. False perfection, doubt from others, isolation, freezing, indecision, self-blame, and physical shutdowns. Narcissists depend on their supply. The people, they're emotionally, financially, and psychologically, they drain you, okay? They need someone to abuse and manipulate for their needs. So whatever a narcissist is doing to you, they do that shit to you on purpose because they feed off of you. They get off on that. Okay? They like hurting you. They like abusing you. They like bullying you. Well, if you don't do this, I'm going to tell your husband or wife. That's blackmailing. That's some bullshit. That's bullying. They'll do anything that they can, YouTube, my followers, my fans, my subscribers. They will do anything to get you to do what they need you to do. So if you know of someone like that, if you know that you're in an abusive relationship like this, you need to get out or work your way around it. Some people can't leave. You have to sit down and write your stuff out. It's best to have a psychiatrist. It's best to have a counselor. Therapist is a psychiatrist. Maybe you have someone that's in your family that's a police officer, detective. Maybe somebody you can go and sit down and talk to. You got to talk to somebody that you can trust where they can help you get out of this situation. Now, abuse shelters for women is not, I wouldn't say, is for everyone. Shelters is not for everyone. Okay? See if you can move in with a family member. See if you can get on housing, Section 8. There's a lot of places that you can join. Talk to your psychiatrist, talk to a counselor, and they know case managers, call social service, but talk to somebody. You need to get this off your chest. You need to talk to somebody. Sometimes it's hard to get out of these situations. Okay? Sometimes it's very hard to get out of these situations. You need help, you know? And especially if you have kids, it's really hard. But this narcissistic behavior and this narcissist, they love getting off on you emotionally, financially, and psychologically. They try to make you feel like you're stupid, like you're dumb, like you're retarded, like you're not smart as they are. And really, they're a pussy. I'm going to call it like it is. They need medication. They need help. But a lot of them do that shit just to do it. Have you ever met a person that just calls you constantly, a person that you're in love with, and they say to you, well, this is your fault because it happened to me. This is your fault. This is your fault. This is your fault. No, bitch, it's your fault. Okay? Now, you know, born with a veil, I'm not going to bite my tongue for nobody. No, it's your goddamn fault for how stupid you are and how ignorant you are, because a lot of times you know what you're doing and you want to take it out on the person that you love the most. You need to go get your ass in therapy. You need to go get some help. That's what you need to do. And don't call me with that dumb shit telling me that it's my fault. See, you need to laugh. You need to, especially if you're separated and you're living apart and they call and they do this to you, you have every right to stick up for yourself. You have every right to defend yourself. But then when you're with somebody that's narcissistic, has narcissistic behavior, that is a narcissist, you got to watch yourself around them because they can hurt you. If you got somewhere to go, run. But plan like you would if you were in an abusive relationship. Say this person was not narcissistic or not a narcissist, okay? And you're with someone that's abusive. Make your plans where you're going to go, how you're going to do it. It's always best to have a counselor or a psychiatrist. That doesn't mean that you're crazy. And let me tell you something, what narcissism is and narcissistic. That bastard will say, you know, you're bipolar. And sometimes you may be bipolar. There's nothing to be ashamed of being bipolar. It's a chemical imbalance that you were born with. Something in your life where you became chemically imbalanced, okay? There's nothing wrong with that. Never feel ashamed of that, okay? But a narcissistic person will say to you, yeah, you know, you need to take your medication because, you know, you got a very bad temper. And I see some things in you that you need to work on. Bitch, what about you? What does your ass need to work on? You need to shut the fuck up talking to me. And number two, I'm going to tell you just like it is, YouTube. Number two, your narcissistic ass needs to go get a psychiatrist and a counselor, and your ass needs to be on some medication. Don't tell me what I need. You know what? I give a person credit that has got a psychiatrist, that's got a counselor, they got a case manager, somebody that they're talking to. You know you got a chemical imbalance. There's something wrong and you're fixing it. It's that bastard that's telling you what you should be doing when their ass should be in therapy. And always pretending like they're better than you, like they got so much going on. They ain't got shit going on, but narcissistic behavior. So don't let nobody belittle you, because you come at me, I'ma cuss your ass out. And you could call me bipolar, you could call me whatever you want to be, whatever you think I should be, I'ma cuss your ass out. I'm real, okay? I am very real. I just don't let nobody pick on me. I don't give a damn. You can go to hell, because you're not going to sit up here and pick on Vail and call me all kind of names and think that you're going to do what you want to, because I'm going to tap that ass. I'm going to get you in another way that you can't even handle. So, you know, it's hard being married to a narcissistic, a person that's a narcissist, that has narcissistic ways. Narcissism. It's very, very hard. I know. I know. They're abusive, they're cruel, they're mean, they think they do no wrong, but they want to come at you and tell you what's wrong with you. You better go check you, honey. You need to go check on you, because see, I'm checking on me. Anything that's wrong with me, I'm getting hell for, but you need to go check on you. Don't worry about what this one's doing over here. You need to worry about your own ass, because you got a mental illness and something wrong with you. And you need to go get that checked. Okay? So my point is, ladies and men, if you're, I applaud you if you're getting help. And then also you need to talk to a counselor, a therapist, if you're dealing with a narcissist. You really do, because that's not even funny. And some of you are in relationships like that too. So think what you want, say what you want. If you got a comment, if you're with a narcissist, or you know somebody that's got narcissistic behaviors, and someone that's just full of shit, period. Because I'm going to tell you something. If you know you're a narcissist, and you're doing this stuff to people, emotionally and financially and psychologically, you're crazy as hell. You're wrong for that. But see, that shit's going to come back on you. When you play with people's emotions like that, you want to sit on the phone and call them, oh, everything is your fault. Let me tell you something. You could be in a relationship, okay? And they'll call and tell you, well, you know, you didn't do this today. You didn't do that today. And, oh, you're screwing this one. You're doing that. You're doing this. And all along, their ass is doing it. They're doing it. Everything that a narcissist says to you, they're doing it. Believe that. So if you didn't know what narcissistic behavior is and you didn't know what a narcissist is, Veil done told you tonight. That she done told you tonight, honey. A narcissist, once again, can a narcissist love you? They acknowledge your existence when you serve your purpose to their ass. And they know they're a narcissist. The only reason why some narcissists want you is so you can fucking take care of them, so you can supply their needs financially, emotionally, and sexually. But don't mess up with one of them. Honey, you the worst thing since chopped liver. They will use you, baby, till they can't use you no more. And I'm going to tell you another thing that they do. They'll tell you, oh, I love you, baby. You're enough woman for me. I love you. And they got 10 hoes on the side. You're the only one that I love. Oh, the sex is so good. The pussy is so good. You're the only one that I love. And here they are being a hoe with 10 other ones. Telling them the same thing. And then you got them hitting you up. Do you know such and such? Do you know such and such? Because they told me the same thing. They know what they do. Okay? They're trying to make you look like a damn idiot, a damn fool, but you're not. So, Born With A Veil just wanted to tell you that, okay? So, God bless you. I wish you the best in your relationships. If there's anything I could help you with, comment below. If you'd like a reading, 313-401-3707. My readings are still $25 for a half an hour. Spiritual consultation, I could do it for $100 an hour. But if you are narcissistic yourself, you need help. If you're narcissistic, if you're a narcissist and you know what you're doing to people, you need help. Because that karma is going to bite you in your ass for what you're doing to people. So this is Born With A Veil. God bless everyone. Have a great night. And thank you for being a fan. Thank you, Cross Watchers. And this is all the signs from Aries all the way to Sagittarius. God bless you.